Welcome to episode 4 of the Brain Surgeon's Vlog. We're in Theatre 11 with Ellen and Stephen. They're neuro scrub nurses, and I'm going to take you on a little tour of the Neuro Operating Theatre. Good evening. We are here in the Neurosurgery Operating Theatre. I'm going to give you a lowdown of all the different kinds of equipment that we use, starting with this bad boy just behind me. This is the Neurosurgery Operating Microscope, and we use this for all of our cranial and spinal cases. So that's for the brain surgery and the spinal surgery, and it's a really, really important tool to be able to see things that are less than a millimeter. This, which is what we use to drive the machine, and as you can see, because it's already been auto-balanced, this hardly needs any kind of energy through it to move it. It's very ergonomic, very nicely designed, very well balanced. And we can use this during the operation to get really incredible views of very, very minute anatomy. The operating microscope is usually set up like this. The patient is going to be laying on the bed like this, with the head up at this end. And then the surgeon can either stand to the left of the patient, at the head end, or on the other side. And then an assistant can help the operating surgeon by standing on the other side or just next to them. When the patient is on the operating table here, how do we keep the head fixed in position so that we can move it around and keep it rigid? It's very, very important when you're doing microsurgery on structures that are less than a millimeter in size that you don't get any movement of the head whatsoever. One of the key ways to do this is using a Mayfield clamp. This is a pretty barbaric thing. This is it with these horrible pins in there. The pins will make a hole through the skin and they will dig into the patient's skull to keep everything rigid and fixed in place. But those holes will heal up on their own. There's no lasting damage. You've just got to be super careful of where you're pinning a patient. So if you want to see something really freaky, this is how we balance the arm of the operating microscope. And it does something that just reminds me of the Terminator, and it's super freaky. And I don't like it, but it's super cool at the same time. Moving on, while this keeps doing its own thing, this is the anaesthetic room, and this is where a patient is wheeled in from the other side. The anaesthetist, the ODP, and another anaesthetic trainee will help to put the patient to sleep. We've got these x-ray gowns, and the x-ray gowns are really good for when we're doing spinal procedures. That's when we need an x-ray guidance to help us get the right level in the back. We don't want to be operating on the wrong level of the patient. The anaesthetic machine. This keeps the patient alive and breathing whilst the neurosurgeon is operating on the patient's brain or spine. Super important, and even more important, the anaesthetic machine is the anaesthetist that makes it all work. That was a whirlwind tour of the Neurosurgery Operating Theatre, Theatre 11 at the Royal London Hospital. I hope you enjoyed the episode. Next time we're going to see a little bit more of the operating theatre and maybe the CT scanners. Bye from
Stephen
and
Ellen.
See you later. Don't forget to subscribe.